it's all about love. When you feel it for someone, it takes over your mind.
Jim, I don't know if I've ever felt it before.
You know when you feel it. You go crazy. They're all you think about.
I don't know, it doesn't seem real.
You need to feel it to be real.
Supposed to know when I feel it.
You're still young. Go live some life.
Sarah! Sarah, it's me, Derek, from last night.
Derek, what do you want?
My watch. I left it in your room last night.
And?
What? Can I come up and get it?
Yeah. I guess so.
Great.
So, do you remember where you left it?
No, I just took it off in a rush. Last night I kind of threw it and I don't know.
Well, maybe it's on the other side of the bed?
Yeah, I can have a look. Yeah. Chance to read this letter I left you.
Letter?
Yeah.
No.
What?
I'm literally just awake.
Well, do you want to read it now?
Not really. Maybe later.
Sure.
Did you find the watch?
No. I can't see it anywhere. If you find it, will you let me know?
Yeah. Not everything?
Yeah, I think so.
Great, well, see you later, I guess.
Yeah, definitely. If you do read the letter, will you just, you know, let me know, because it kind of says how I feel about you. Jim, you're not gonna believe what happened today.
What? Tell me.
I met the girl I'm gonna marry.
Who is she?
She's a waitress. She works up on Hanover Road. I think I'm in love.
I'm happy for you.
Yeah, man. It happened so fast. She came out of nowhere and, you know, we locked eyes and she was pouring my coffee and I said, hey, listen, can I get your number? Sarah.
Derek, what do you want?
I was just wondering, did you find my watch?
No, I didn't see anything.
Well, I think I remember where it is. Can I come up and have a look?
Listen, Derek, if I find it, I'll let you know.
Sarah, did you read the note?
No, I didn't read it, and I don't plan to either.
Why? I wrote it especially for you, it's...
Because, Derek, we were both drunk. More drunk than I've been for a long time. So you should just forget about it and move on.
I wasn't that drunk, Sarah. I remember the whole night.
Listen, Derek, it was a one-time thing. Just forget about it.
Listen, how about you read the note, and I'll go now and I'll come back tomorrow and we can see how we are then.
Do not come back here tomorrow.
Why? What's wrong? Why? What's wrong? I don't get it.
Because, Derek, you're a sad little man. You're so fucking terrified of being lonely that he harasses women to the point where they're afraid to look out their bedroom window in fear of seeing you.
I was just being friendly. Like, I don't get it. Do you like me? Do you not like me?
I don't like you. I never did. The only reason you got with me that night is because I was blackout drunk. I would have gotten with anybody.
Well, what am I supposed to do now?
I don't care. Just leave me alone.
Sarah.
How do I get it to notice me?
You gotta make some big romantic gesture. Pour your heart out. Let her know how much you love her. Then she'll fall for you. It's guaranteed to happen. That's how I got my wife.
Yeah? How did you guys meet?
She used to work in a bar down the road from me. I was always too nervous and too shy to approach her. So I sent her a dozen roses, saying from Jim. The rest is history.
Jim, I don't think this girl's gonna be that easy. She's, this girl's special.
Yeah. But just do something from the heart, man. And she'll love it. She'll love you for it.
Sarah, look, I don't know if you're there. I just wanted to let you know that I love you. That night was the best night of my life, and I was just wondering if maybe you wanted to go out with me again. Sorry, is Sarah there?
She doesn't want to see you.
Can I ask why?
She says you're a sad, lonely man who needs some serious help.
Look, can you give her this letter from me?
No.
Sarah, look, I know you're there. I just want to talk to you for a minute.
You need to leave.
Sarah, please, can I just talk to you for a minute?
Seriously, leave now.
Well, look, will you at least tell her I was here?
No. Now leave.
I won't ever love again.
Look, there's plenty more fish in the sea. That's how I met my second wife.
Jim, she was perfect and I messed it up. I ruined it and now I'm gonna be alone. I'm unlovable.
It's gonna hurt for a while. But now is the worst part. You'll get better, trust me.
Just, it doesn't feel like there's any outcome in this where I don't end up alone.
Anything. What's wrong with you?
It's Sarah. She hates me.
So?
Get over her. I can't, Simon. It's different. She was perfect, Simon.
You had sex once, drunk. How could she be perfect?
She just was. She's amazing, and now she's never gonna feel the same way about me.
Look, you can't keep falling in love with every girl that you get with, or that you talk to, or even that you look at.
I understand.
You're going to have to grow up. Start being a man. Come on. We'll go out and we'll forget all about Sarah.
Don't say her name, Simon.
Come on. Get up and stop moaning.
Why? What's the point of me going anywhere? Because
if you don't, I'll drag you out of that bed, alright? Now come on.
Fine. Fine. I'll go.
Yeah, go ahead. I'm Barry.
Alice.
Nice to meet you.